Good morning, all praises to the Most High. Thank you for waking us up today. Forgive us for our iniquities, Father God. Let this lesson edify and teach those that are in need. And we're thankful. We give you all the glory, praise, and worship, O Heavenly Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Today, we're going to be talking about the importance of faith. We're going to start in the book of Numbers, chapter 13, verse 26. At this time, Moses and Aaron sent spies out to survey the land that was promised to them by the Most High. The spies came back and they made a report of what they seen or saw. I just wanted to go over this because I thought that this was important. This was an important lesson in regards to faith. So we're going to start from verse chapter 13 in Numbers, King James Version, verse 26. And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him and said, we came unto the land whither thou sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey, and this is the fruit of it. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites, and the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the mountains. And the Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. Caleb, remember this, Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. Caleb, like, he was ready to go. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. So those two verses, verse 30 and verse 31, you got one servant of the Most High, Caleb, who's showing faith in the Most High. Then you got the men that went up with him that are showing doubt, expressing doubt. So Caleb's expressing faith in the Most High because you know that all things can be done. You know what I mean? The Most High is real. You know, the Most High brought them out of many situations, probably more dangerous than the one that they're talking about. But the men with their eyes, with their carnal eyes, seeing what they were up against, and they thought that they weren't ready. Verse 31, but the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. And verse 32, and they brought up an evil report of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. And all the people that we saw in it are men of a great stature. So to me, they sound scared, right? To me, they sound scared. They sound worried. They doubting. You know what I mean? These are all traits that are not of the Most High. For he did not give us a spirit of fear, but of power and a sound mind. In verse 33, and there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers. And so we were in their sight. So the ending of this verse, I wanted to add to this lesson because I thought it'll tie into chapter 14. But we can see that Caleb had faith in the Most High. Yeah. And we see that the men that went with him didn't. We see that they doubted. We see that they were scared. We see that they were worried. We see that they were fearful. So chapter 14 will tell us what happens as a result. 14, verse 1. And all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried, and the people wept that night. They ain't know what to believe. They like, Caleb said we could go, but you guys said we can't go. Like, something's wrong. And all, verse 2, and all the children of Israel murmured against Moses and against Aaron. And the whole congregation said unto them, would God that we had died in the land of Egypt, or would God we had died in this wilderness? So a lack of faith from those men was so contagious that it spread through the whole congregation of Israel. All the children of Israel began to murmur against Moses and against Aaron again, right? Because of those few people that had lack of faith. Now, it would have been different if they would have showed faith, because that faith that they showed would have probably been contagious, and they would have rallied up the troops and all the children of Israel. But the lack of faith, we see that it's contagious, right? So if one person lacks faith, then, you know, it's easier for another person to lack faith, because hey, he said that they were great, in great stature. So I believe him. We can't beat them, instead of, you know, being like Caleb. And also they said, they questioned Moses and Aaron and also God. They're like, would God want us to die in the land of Egypt, or did he want us to die in the wilderness? Because we don't know. So verse 3 says, and wherefore hath the Most High brought us unto this land? And wherefore has the Most High brought us unto this land to fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey? Were it not better for us to return into Egypt? After all the Most High did for them, that's why it's very important to count your blessings. You can't forget where you came from. You can't forget your trials and tribulations, because they made you who you are today. Your faith in the Most High is so important. You got to remember the circumstances that he brought you out of before. So if he brought you out of those circumstances, if he brought you out of the land of Egypt, if he sent the 10 plagues to the Pharaoh of Egypt so that he can let you go, what makes you think he's just going to just abandon you all of a sudden? He's with you. The cloud followed them throughout the wilderness. Manna came from the sky. Like, there's so many blessings that they could have counted at this time, but they choose to just stay in a moment about this one situation. So this tells me that their foundation was built off of sand and straws. It wasn't built off a rock and a stone. It's kind of wavery. Their faith is wavery. Verse 4. And they said one to another, let us make a captain and let us return into Egypt. So they were so fearful, lack of faith, that they rather go back to Egypt, back into bondage, than journey into a land of the unknown, because they didn't know what to expect. That's why it's important. That's why the Bible says we walk by faith, not by sight. Because if you would, because they're walking by sight. They see the men of great stature. They see all the Canaanites and all the people that's in the land that they're getting ready to inherit. So, but they're not walking by faith, right? They're walking by sight. That's why it's important to walk by faith and not by sight. So they even want a cap. They wanted a captain. They want to go back into bondage. So this should tell you how much fear and doubt and worry that they got. Verse 5, then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before all the assembly of the congregation of the children of Israel. Couldn't believe it. I wouldn't blame them. And Joshua, the son of Nun, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, which were of them that searched the land, rent their clothes. So we got Joshua and Caleb also tearing their clothes up. They just can't believe it. And they spoke unto all the company of the children of Israel, saying, the land which we passed through to search it is an exceeding good land. Verse 8, if the Lord delight in us, then he will bring us into this land and give it us, a land which floweth with milk and honey. Only rebel not ye against the Most High, neither fear ye the people of the land. Insert, we know that the fear of the Most High is the beginning of wisdom, but they fear the people of the land, for they are bread for us. Their defense is departed from them, and the Most High Yah is with us. fear them not. You should be fearing the Most High. You fearing another human. You fearing the wrong person. You fearing the wrong thing. You worrying about them, you should be fearing the Creator of all of us, basically. But all the congregation based on with them. But all the congregation based on them with stones. They was getting, congregation didn't want to hear that. They didn't want to hear no more fear the Most High, fear God, have faith. And there's people out there today that they don't want to hear about God. They going through something. Their circumstances is dictating their faith. So it's hard to tell somebody to believe in the Most High and have faith. They don't want to hear that. And we know same way back in that day. They ain't want to hear that. They ain't want to hear that so much that they was getting ready to stone them. They was getting ready to stone them. And the glory of the Most High appeared in the tabernacle of the congregation, verse 10, before all the children of Israel, verse 11. And the Most High said unto Moses, how long will this people provoke me? Now, the Most High is getting upset now. I don't blame them. After all I done did, they still want to doubt me. They still want to provoke me by having little ye of faith. And how long will it be ere they believe me for all the signs which I have showed among them? I just showed them the signs. I just said this. I just showed them everything I did. That's why it's important to count your blessings. Don't get stuck in the moment. Count your blessings. I will smite them with the pestilence and disinherit them. And will make of thee a great nation and mightier than they. Verse 12. Most High is sick. He's done with them. Verse 13. And Moses said unto the Most High, then the Egyptians shall hear it, for thou broughtest up this people in thy might from among them. Verse 14. And they will tell it to the inhabitants of this land, for they have heard that the Lord art among this people, that the Lord art seen face to face, and that thy cloud standeth over them, and that thou goest before them by daytime in a pillar of a cloud and in a pillar of fire by night. So basically Moses is saying, if you smite all of us, then Egyptians going to know, then the people where we're going to inherit the land going to know. And it's like, why, you know, Moses is interceding right now. He's interceding with the Most High in prayer for his people. Now, verse 15. Now, if thou shalt kill all this people as one man, then the nations which have heard the fame of thee will speak, saying, verse 16, because the Lord was not able to bring this people into the land which he sware unto them, therefore he hath slain them in the wilderness. Basically, you kill us, Father God. This is what they're going to start talking. Oh, the Most High, he brought them out, but he still slain them. Those are supposed to be the chosen people. Verse 17. And now I beseech thee, I beg thee, let the power of my Lord be great according as thou hast spoken, saying, the Most High is long suffering and of great mercy, forgiving iniquity and transgression, and by no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation. Pardon, I beseech thee, the iniquity of this people according unto the greatness of thy mercy, and as thou hast forgiven this people from Egypt even unto now. So Moses is basically standing in prayer for his people, for all the children of Israel. He didn't have to do this. And look how the Most High responds. And the Lord said, I have pardoned according to thy word. So we see that you can pray for people. You can intercede for people in prayer. The Most High only hears the righteous, but turns his back to the unrighteous. So Moses did that. He prayed for his people. He prayed that the Most High don't smite all his people. Right? Because he knew that if he was to do that, then word would have got out and the Egyptians would have questioned, like, wow, did all that to, you know, the Most High freed his people from us to kill them in the wilderness. Then the people that's in the land that they're getting ready to inherit, they would have heard that. Like, wow, the Most High really didn't care for his people. So Moses stood in prayer and interceded for his people, and the Most High heard it and pardoned them. Right? So that's something that you can take as well. You can pray for people. You can intercede for people. Right? Verse 21. But as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Most High. Verse 22, because all those men which have seen my glory and my miracles, which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness, and have tempted me now, these 10 times have not hearkened to my voice. You done seen what I did, man. And you still doubting? You still want to tempt me? Okay. Verse 23. Surely they shall not see the land which I swore unto their fathers, neither shall any of them that provoked me see it. But my servant Caleb, remember Caleb in chapter 13, he was the one that, chapter 13, verse 30, he said, Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. He had the faith. Right, he was the only one that had the faith, him and Joshua. Now, verse 24, but my servant Caleb, because he had another spirit with him, he didn't have the spirit of fear, right? Doubt. He didn't have the spirit of doubt. He didn't have the spirit of worry. He had another spirit different from the people of that went with him. He had the spirit of faith and have followed me fully, not partially, fully, because God, we know God is without partiality. Him will I bring into the land whereinto he went, and his seed shall possess it. And we know Caleb is of the tribe of Judah, so that makes a lot of sense. Now the Amalekites and the Canaanites dwelt in the valley. Tomorrow turn you and get you into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. Verse 26. And when the Most High spoke unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, verse 27, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation which murmur against me? I have heard murmurings of the children of Israel which they murmur against me. Say unto them, as truly as I live, verse 28, saith the Most High, as ye have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you. Verse 29, your carcasses shall fall in the wilderness, and all that were numbered of you, according to your whole number, from 20 years old and upward, which have murmured against me. Doubtless, ye shall not come into the land. Doubtless, you shall not come into the land concerning which I swear to you, to make you dwell therein, save Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, and Joshua, the son of Nun. But your little ones, which ye said should be a prey, them will I bring in, and they shall know the land which ye have despised. So those that lack the faith and doubt, worry, you're not making it to the land that I promised, that's flowing with milk and honey. You're not, just because of that, you're not going to make it. Verse 31, he said, your little ones, though, which you said should be a prey, them will I bring in. They shall know the land which ye have despised. But as for you, your carcasses, verse 32, they shall fall in the wilderness. Verse 33, and your children shall wander in the wilderness 40 years and bear your whoredoms until your carcasses be wasted in the wilderness. Verse 34, after the number of the days in which ye search the land, even 40 days, each day for a year, shall ye bear your iniquities, even 40 years, and ye shall know my breach of promise. The Most High have said, I will surely do it unto all this evil congregation that are gathered together against me. In this wilderness they shall be consumed, and there they shall die. He called them an evil congregation. What were they practicing? They wasn't practicing the ways of the Most High, because they would have knew what time it was. They would have never doubted. So they was practicing evil. But the evil was coming out of their mouth. They not even knowing it. They're murmuring against him. He said, how long would I hear these murmurs? Like, you know? These are my children, but still. Like, they don't get it. I think we're on verse 36. Yep. And the men which Moses sent to search the land, who returned and made all the congregation to murmur against him, by bringing up a slander upon the land, verse 37, even those men that did bring up the evil report upon the land died by the plague before the Most High. But Joshua, the the son of Nun, Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, which were of the men that went to search the land, lived still. And Moses told these sayings unto all the children of Israel, and the people mourned greatly. Now you mourning because you know you made a great mistake. You know that, but it's too late now. You know, the Most High didn't pity with y'all. Moses didn't have to intercede for y'all. You know, verse 40, and they rose up early in the morning and got them up in the top of the mountain, saying, lo, we be here and will go up unto the place which the Lord hath promised, for we have sinned. Now you want to go up. Now you want to have this faith. That's not real faith, though. You know what I mean? It's not real faith. You heard what Moses said. You heard what Moses told you guys. You mourned. You realized. You slept on it. You woke up the next early in the morning. Now you want to be renewed with faith. It don't work like that. And we'll go up to the place the Lord promised me. I said, verse 41. And Moses said, wherefore now do ye transgress the commandment of the Most High? But it shall not prosper. Go not up. It's a warning. Go not up, for the Most High is not among you, that ye may be not smitten before your enemies. But knowing them, they probably wanted to die anyway. Like, man, either they wanted to die or they didn't care. I don't know. But they got the warning. Moses told them not to go up. The Lord is not with them. Verse 43. For the Amalekites and the Canaanites are there before you, and ye shall fall by the sword, warning, because ye are turned away from the Most High. Therefore the Most High will not be with you. But they presume to go up unto the hilltop. Nevertheless, the Ark of the Covenant and the Most High and Moses departed not out of the camp. So they left, but the Ark of the Covenant and Moses did not leave. Then the Amalekites came down, and the Canaanites, which dwelt in that hill, and smote them and discomfited them, even unto Hadar. There you have it, man. So we know that the Most High is not playing with his people. You know what I mean? We know that if he says something, he means it. You know what I mean? And those that doubt, those that have doubt, and you rather fear people than fear your creator, and you rather worry, God is not pleased with that, man. You die. Fear, doubt, and worry kills. Faith in the Most High doesn't. You know what I mean? So this is a lesson right here, man. They seen their circumstances, right? They seen they was in the wilderness. They seen the great stature of people that they were getting ready to inherit the land from. They got scared. They was fearful. They didn't really have true faith, right? So it's like the separation. It's like the separation from the wheat and the tares, right? God just not going to believe you just because you around people that have faith. You got to have your own faith. Caleb's faith couldn't help them, right? But Moses' prayer helped a little bit because the Most High didn't kill the whole congregation. He let their offsprings advance, you know what I mean, to the land. He said, those 20 and up, those that provoked me, those that doubted me, I will smite them. But those of your offsprings, I will let them inherit the land. So that's important. You know what I mean? And I just wanted to share that message with you guys. Whatever you're going through in your life, you know, no matter what your circumstance may look like, never fear, never doubt, or never worry. You know what I mean? You are human. You know, but if you could, you know, all you need is faith of a mustard seed. Right? That's all you need. In 2 Timothy, was it chapter 1, verse 7 says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear. So when that spirit of fear, doubt, or worry come into you, that you know that's not of God. That's why he called those people an evil congregation, because that wasn't the spirit. And he also said Caleb had a different spirit, right? So we know what was working in those camps and in the congregation. We know that the enemy was working his spirit of fear upon his people, because that was contagious. That spirit of fear was so contagious that it transferred through the whole congregation. The whole congregation began to murmur against the Most High. It was about 12 people that went up to spy on the land, and Caleb, I think Joshua, was the only two people that had the spirit of faith, and the rest of the people was fearful. So those 10 people came back and made everybody in the congregation fearful, basically. So we know that's contagious. The spirit of fear is contagious. And we know that's not of God. We know that's not of the Most High. So we know if it's not of the Most High, we know it's of the enemy. So we can't have that in our body. We can't have that in our soul, in our spirit, in our mind. So it's very important to learn from these things, man. For God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It never changes. I just want to thank you guys for allowing me to share this message with you. Whatever you're going through, don't fear, don't doubt, don't worry. Everything's going to be all right. Pray. Intercede. If you see somebody else fearing and doubting and worrying, you can intercede for them as Moses did for his people. And always count your blessings. You know, don't get stuck in the moment just because God ain't do something for you right now. Think about all the times he did do something for you. Right? Don't never forget that, because that's how you strengthen faith. And make sure your foundation is built of stone and rock, something that can't be moved or wavered. You see that their foundation was built off straws, sand, you know. So when they seen these people, they wavered in faith, right? Oh, ye of little faith. So I just wanted to share that message with you guys. I pray that God blesses you. Pray that all your spiritual attributes are enhanced. And I'll see you next time with another lesson. God bless you all. Thank you.